Hand hygiene. Hands are the main pathways of germ transmission during healthcare. Healthcare-associated pathogens can be recovered not only from infected or draining wounds, but also from frequently colonized areas of normal, intact patient skin.
Direct patient contact and respiratory tract care are most likely to contaminate the fingers of caregivers. Gram-negative bacilli accounted for 15% of isolates and Staphylococcus aureus for 11%. Several studies have shown the ability of microorganisms to survive on hands for differing times. Both Enterococcus faecalis and Enterococcus faecium survived for at least 60 minutes on gloved and ungloved fingertips. Pseudomonas aeruginosa and Burkholderia sepacia were transmissible by handshaking for up to 30 minutes when the organisms were suspended in saline, and up to 180 minutes when they were suspended in sputum. Shigella dysentery type 1 showed its capacity to survive on hands for up to 1 hour.
Hands of a caregiver are seen as a protector of human life, but they are also a potential vehicle for transmission of infection. Healthcare workers' hands become progressively colonized with commensal flora as well as with potential pathogens during patient care. Bacterial contamination increases linearly over time. In the absence of hand hygiene, the longer the duration of care, the higher the degree of hand contamination. Whether care is provided to adults or neonates, both the duration and the type of patient care affect healthcare workers' hand contamination. The dynamics of hand contamination are similar on gloved versus ungloved hands. Gloves reduce hand contamination but do not fully protect from acquisition of bacteria during patient care. Therefore, the glove surface is contaminated, making cross-transmission through contaminated gloves likely. WHO report shows that approximately 70% of healthcare workers and 50% of surgical teams do not routinely practice hand hygiene. This increases chances of infection. Hand hygiene is the most effective preventive measure against healthcare-associated infections. Hand hygiene serves 4 important purposes. 1. It prevents healthcare-associated infections in patients. 2. Prevents cross-transmission of organisms between patients. 3. Prevents contamination of infection in hospital environment with potential pathogens. 4. It finally protects healthcare workers from occupational diseases. Objectives. Indications for hand hygiene. Hand hygiene techniques, that is, hand rub with alcohol-based product and hand wash with soap and water. Hand hygiene equipment. Appropriate use of gloves. Policies on jewelry and fingernail hygiene. Selected complications associated with hand hygiene. Hand hygiene to prepare for surgical procedures is not discussed in this video. Hand hygiene equipment. To perform adequate hand hygiene, you will need 1. Alcohol-based hand rub. 2. Soap. 3. Water. And 4. Drying agents such as disposable paper or towels. Use alcohol-based hand rub with proven antimicrobial efficacy. They usually contain 60 to 80% isopropanol, ethyl alcohol, and N-propanol, or a combination of these products. These hand rubs are supplemented with skin emollients to protect the skin. Containers of these products should be easily available, usually within arm's reach, either at the point of care or within 3 feet of point of likely use, or may be carried by healthcare workers for personal use. Soaps are chemicals that can remove lipids and dirt. The antibacterial effect of soaps is due to their ability to dislodge pathogens from the skin when combined with rinsing effect of running water. The indications for hand hygiene have been defined by numerous organizations, including the CDC and the WHO. We will now review some indications. Let us understand some basics of transmission of microorganisms. The skin and the mucous membranes of every human being are colonized by microorganisms. When hospitalized patients gradually shed these microorganisms, onto inanimate objects in their surroundings, for example, onto bed linen, bedside equipment, or furniture, the environment immediately around a patient is called the patient zone. As a result of exposure and contamination by healthcare workers and patients, other areas of the hospital, for example, corridors or other patient rooms, are also colonized with microorganisms. Cross-transmission of potential pathogens from one environment to another occurs through hands of healthcare workers. Hand hygiene greatly reduces this cross-transmission of pathogens. Hand hygiene must be performed at various moments of contact with patients and their surroundings. 1. Before touching a patient. 2. Before clean or aseptic procedure. 3. After body fluid exposure risk. 4. After touching a patient. And 5. After touching patient surroundings. Before touching a patient, why? To protect the patient against colonization and in some cases, against exogenous infection by harmful germs carried on your hands. When? Clean your hands before touching a patient when approaching him or her. Before clean or aseptic procedure, why? To protect the patient against infection with harmful germs, including his or her own germs entering his or her body. When? Clean your hands immediately before accessing a critical site with infectious risk for the patient, for example, a mucous membrane, non-intact skin, and invasive medical device. After body fluid exposure risk, why? To protect you from colonization or infection with patients' harmful germs and to protect the healthcare environment from germ spread. When? Clean your hands as soon as the task involving an exposure risk to body fluids has ended and after glove removal. After touching a patient, why? To protect you from colonization with patient germs and to protect the healthcare environment from germ spread. When? Clean your hands when leaving the patient's side after having touched the patient. After touching patient surroundings, why? To protect you from colonization with patient germs that may be present on surfaces or objects in patient surroundings and to protect the healthcare environment against germ spread. When? Clean your hands after touching any object or furniture when leaving the patient's surroundings without having touched the patient. Hand hygiene techniques. There are two recognized techniques for hand hygiene. 1. Hand rubbing with alcohol-based formulation. 2. Hand washing with soap and water. To perform hand rubbing, rub hands for hand hygiene. Wash hands when visibly soiled. The duration of the entire procedure should last about 20 to 30 seconds. Apply a palmful of the product in a cupped hand covering all surfaces. Rub hands palm to palm. Right palm over the left dorsum with interlaced fingers and vice versa. Palm to palm with fingers interlaced. Back of fingers to opposing palms with fingers interlocked. Rotational rubbing of left thumb clasped in right palm and vice versa. Rotational rubbing backwards and forwards with clasped fingers of right hand in left palm and vice versa. Once dry, your hands are safe. To perform hand washing, wash hands when visibly soiled, otherwise use hand rub. Duration of the entire procedure should last about 40 to 60 seconds. Wet hands with water. Apply enough soap to cover all hand surfaces. Rub hands palm to palm. Right palm over left dorsum with interlaced fingers and vice versa. Palm to palm with fingers interlaced to opposing palms with fingers interlocked. Rotational rubbing of left thumb clasped in right palm and vice versa. rotational rubbing backwards and forwards with clasped fingers, right hand and left palm, and vice versa. Rinse hands with water. Dry hands thoroughly with a single-use towel. Use towel to turn off the faucet. Your hands are now safe.
There are few specific indications where hand washing is preferred over hand rubbing. Visible contamination of hands with blood or body fluids. Visible contamination with proteinaceous material. Exposure to spore-forming organisms, for example, after caring for patients with diarrhea due to Clostridium difficile or after exposure to Bacillus anthracis. Or after using restroom.
Appropriate use of gloves. Gloves serve two different purposes. One, they reduce transmission of microorganisms from healthcare workers' hands to patients. Two, they protect healthcare workers from getting infection from patients. The use of gloves does not replace the need for cleaning your hands. Hand hygiene must be performed when appropriate, regardless of the indications for glove use. Remove gloves to perform hand hygiene when an indication occurs while wearing gloves. Discard gloves after each task and clean your hands. Gloves may carry microorganisms. Gloves must be worn according to standard and contact precautions. Sterile gloves are not required during routine patient care. Clean non-sterile examination gloves may be used for exposure to blood, body fluids, mucous membranes and non-intact skin, and also for manipulation of invasive devices.
Gloves must also be worn when caring for patients who are colonized or infected with pathogens transmitted by contact route. For example, methicillin-resistant Staphylococcus aureus, vancomycin-resistant enterococci, or other multi-drug-resistant pathogens.
You must always perform hand hygiene after removing gloves, since gloves may have defects that result in transmission of microorganisms. Alcohol may degrade glove material and lead to holes and leakage. For this reason, do not disinfect or reuse gloves. Jewelry and fingernail hygiene. Wearing jewelry, such as rings, increases the bacterial load. Do not wear rings or other jewelry during patient care. Long fingernails have been associated with infection outbreaks of resistant pathogens in hospitals. As a result, you must keep fingernails short, that is, less than 0.2 inches or 0.5 centimeters in length, and refrain from wearing artificial nails.
Nail polish is acceptable provided its integrity is preserved. However, fingernail diseases, such as onychomycosis, should be promptly treated as they reduce the efficacy of hand hygiene.
Skin irritation. There are some common problems associated with hand hygiene. Irritation dermatitis can occur after repeated use of hand hygiene products. Common symptoms include dryness, itching, and sometimes cracking and bleeding. In rare cases, allergic dermatitis can occur. Damaged skin is more difficult to disinfect and may be more susceptible to skin colonization, leading to enhanced transmission of infectious pathogens. Strategies to prevent skin irritation. 1. Use skincare products frequently during work hours. For example, creams or moisturizers. 2. Favor use of alcohol-based hand wraps with emollients. 3. Avoid use of hot water while washing hands. 4. Refrain from using gloves unless specifically needed. 5. Dry your hands completely after hand washing. Fire hazard. Alcohols are flammable. Although very rare, flash fires involving healthcare workers' hands may occur if they touch open flame or if a static spark occurs if hands are coated with alcohol. To prevent fire incidents, ensure hands are completely dry after hand rub before touching any object. Summary 1. Hand hygiene is a very important, reliable method for reducing healthcare-associated infections. 2. It is a technique which should be mastered by every healthcare worker. 3. Hand hygiene is not optional, it is mandatory. 4. It increases patient and healthcare workers' safety. 5. This is a sign of competency, professionalism, and respect.